All right, so the webinar is now recording, and this is trading with Weis Wave Speed Index. This is part two, which shows setups and trading examples. So we're just waiting for folks to come in. There's a couple attendees that are waiting to come on here. So just give it a minute, and then you can get started. Either way, it'll be this webinar will be recorded so that they can access it on demand from our on-demand library.
Okay. So, Colin, should we start or should
I
wait?
Yeah, go ahead. No, you can go ahead and start.
Okay, hello everybody, and welcome to this webinar. This is part two. We're going to examine how to set up Weis Wave, and we're going to show also some trading examples. Let's see what are the contents will be for today. The indicators, first of all, how to set them up. The speed index, what is speed index and how we're going to use it. To answer the famous question, do the waves repaint? Where to trade and how? And finally, some actual trading examples. So I will be switching back and forth to the presentation and MT5 so I can show you the setups. But before I do that, let me tell you a bit about the indicators. First of all, the Weis Peep Wave and the Weis Wave with Alert, which is the speed index also inside. Both indicators work on any chart, which means regular time frame, tick chart, this is a constant volume chart, range bars, or Renko. As long as your bars contain volume, the indicators will work. They also work with tick volume or with real volume. So our chart would look something like this. We're going to put Weis Peep Wave as the first indicator, Weis Wave with speed index second, and the regular MT5 volume indicator. Most important parameter is to set up the waves. So we have two options to set up the waves, the manual option, which is the manual waves, and the auto waves. The manual option is with the wave direction change. For example, if we say that if the price moves against the current position of 10 pips, then the wave will change. This has an advantage when you are trading in one time frame or a specific tick chart, so you don't have to play around a lot. But it has a disadvantage that if you're switching time frames, you need to adjust all the time the wave setup. And I will explain this later on. The auto waves, on the other hand, can be used in order to set up and trade in different time frames because the auto waves feature, it calculates by itself the actual wave size by setting up only the sensitivity. Okay. I will show this live, of course, on MT5. Very, very important rules to remember. First, in order to have the proper wave, we need to have the proper wave line touching the price swings. As accurate as possible, at least for the recent history. Otherwise, we will get incorrect volume waves and speed index. Rule number two, speed index formed by many bars, it's much more significant than speed index formed by only few bars. And rule number three, Weis Peep Wave must have the same setup with Weis Wave. Otherwise, the peep waves and the volume waves will not match. But let me start showing you some stuff about what is, this is an incorrect wave. Why is it an incorrect wave because we're missing price swings. So as you can see here, we have been missing this swing here. We have been missing this swing up here. Okay, so the correct wave setup is this. We're getting the swings down here. We got this. We also got some swings here, and we also got this swing. This is the correct wave setup to catch the swings. Okay. To answer the famous question, do the waves repaint? Well, the only wave that repaints, might repaint, is the forming one. The rest do not. But we don't really care because this trading method is based on the previous waves, not so much on the forming one. And let me explain exactly how it repaints. Let's assume that we have set up our difference parameter to be 15 pips. What does that mean? It means that if the direction of the price changes 50 pips against from where it's going, then the wave will reverse. So before repaint, we're going to have this. Let's say that we're moving down, the price is moving down. So we're getting the cumulative waves to be red, going down, and we have gone down all the way to 18 pips. Okay, then the price starts moving up. As the price moving up, the waves of the indicator of the forming wave, it's still red that we're going down. Okay, so we are up 7 pips, so we're still red. So if the price moves more than 50 pips up, then the indicator will repaint. So this is what is going to happen after the repaint. So these three bars will become green, okay? But what I said before, it doesn't really matter because there's this trading method. We're not trading on this. We're trading on the history. And I haven't seen a single indicator that doesn't repaint. What is speed index? I mentioned that in the previous webinar. I will say it one more time. Well, the definition is a number that identifies the speed of the wave. It means nothing by itself. And in order to have a meaning, it must be compared with other speed index numbers on the same chart. What does it tell us? It tells us abnormal speed index means change in behavior and also can mean effort versus result on volume waves. We see a change in behavior of speed index when we see something abnormal. And this also means effort versus result on the volume waves. Therefore, it provides us with an alert that something is going to happen. Something is going out of the ordinary. So a high speed index number means a slow wave. A slow wave usually means the price has hard time to move. And a low speed index means a fast wave. Let me show you some examples down here. Okay. This is a daily chart coming from New Zealand. As you can see, the speed index numbers here, 1.2, 2.7, 1.8, 1.2, 2.7. So this would say that these are all regular speed index numbers. And as we start going down here, we see 2.9, then a 7.9. That's a very slow wave. That's an abnormal speed index compared to all the previous ones. So this will give us an alert. Another case of a slow wave is this. We're going down, we have a 6.2, then we see a 25.9. That's a slow wave. And this is a fast one, 1.3. Okay, we'll see how to use this stuff. So what we're going to see on the chart? The information that is available to us from the indicator is the following. We can see the volume of the wave, the cumulative wave, if we like. We can see the pips, that's the price move. Let me go down here. So this 495 is the volume. The 34 is the pip. That's the moves down. And 8 is the number of bars. So we can have the bars, the pips, and the volume. And below or above, we see the speed index. All right. Let me go to the indicator so we can start setting this up. Are there any questions so far? Colin? Let me see if there are any questions. Any questions so far? Let me type it. I guess not. So let me continue. The setup. I took a Euro USD chart here, 1 hour chart. And I will put in first the pip wave. I will not set up anything. I will explain later on. Then I will put Weis Wave. And then I will put the regular volume indicator just to have it. Okay. First, let me turn off the labeling to make it easier. Colin, are you there? Just to make sure people are listening. Can somebody type something? I see some people live. I hope they're listening. So, correct setup. This first thing we need to do is to fix the waves. As we can see here, we're missing swings. We are missing this swing. We are missing this swing. So, I will try to set up the wave. First, I will do it the manual way. So I will go to the Weis Wave indicator, this one. I will set the auto difference to false, and then I will choose the wave direction change. So I will make it 60 points, which is 6 pips. Okay. Now the waves are much better. We're getting the swings. Okay, most of the swings, at least on the recent history. As soon as I have done that, I need to also change the pip wave. So auto difference to true, and then 6 pips or 60 points again. So right now, Weis Wave and pip wave, they match exactly. Let's see what can we do this. Let me show you if I change time frame, what is going to happen. We have set up 6 pips waves. So if I switch to 5 minutes, okay, you will see that we are missing some swings here. Okay, that's the issue with the manual waves. Up here, we can see our setup. So it's 60 points, both indicators. Now, if I want to trade on the 5-minute chart, I can decrease that to 3 pips, for example. Okay, also the other indicator. 3 pips. And we get much better swings. Okay, let me go back to 1 hour. So the 1 hour, it might be too crowded. So the auto difference feature, which I will show you now, is this. I will set the auto difference to true and the sensitivity to 6, for example. Sensitivity can vary from 1 to whatever. Okay, the higher the number, the more sensitive the waves are, we're going to get more waves. So I will change it to 6. So this value now is ignored now, the manual. All right. And I will do the same thing, the auto feature on the pip wave with 6 sensitivity. And we're getting this. Now our settings are shown on the left again. Since we see the sensitivity here at 6, means that we are in the auto sensitivity mode. All right. And this wave difference will change as the chart go along. Now, if I change now to a 5-minute, we will see that it will adjust. So right here, we're at 38 points. And if I switch to a 5-minute, okay, see, it adjusted to 27.5, and we're getting most of the swings. Okay, that's the advantage of the auto difference. If I switch to a 4-hour chart, for example, I need to get the, okay. We're missing some. We need some more sensitivity, for example, for here. But over here, the recent history, we are pretty good. This is what we care about. Now, let's see what we can set up on the indicator. As soon as we have set up the swings, we can see the other options that the indicator has. Okay, this corner to display and all these Y parameters is where it's going to display our setup, which is this corner on the left. The volume divider, I will show it later on. Let me first of all show the labels. So the labels that I mentioned before, there we go. Right now, it's the volume and the pip movement. Okay, I can change that to whatever I like, meaning, for example, if I want to see only the volume, or only the pips, or only the bars, or everything, or the volume and the pips, I can change this parameter here. So if I want to see everything, if I change this parameter to 4, we see everything. We see the volume, the pips, and the bars. If I change this parameter to 1, I will see only the volume. Okay, I think I got a question. Let me see, because I don't see my screen. No connection. Golden. Nothing works. Connie, can you see me at least? Can you hear me? Okay. Hold on a second, guys. We have a problem with some people not able to see the webinar. If somebody has viewing this and is viewing this okay, please type something.
Yeah, sometimes you have to use the Chrome browser instead of Firefox because it does it might try. You can try Opera because it may knock out the microphone or the sound.
Me, I'm using Chrome.
Yeah, right. I'm using Chrome too, and it works fine. And there's another person in the webinar here that can hear as well.
Okay. What should I do? Should I wait or continue?
I would continue because it's being recorded, Peter, so you can always grab it from our website, and all attendees will get a copy. So continue.
So let me continue then. So from this setup here, what to display, we can choose, as I said, what information we would like to display on the chart. Now, if, for example, the volume is too big and it's getting crowded, this indicator has the following option. Let me show you what I mean. First of all, let me make it to display everything, four. So right now we displayed everything, the volume, the pips, and the number of bars. So right now, if I do the volume divider, the numbers are huge. Okay, when we get huge number, because we're trading different pairs, different instruments, and the volumes can get really big, what the indicators give you the opportunity to divide this number, okay, with this volume divider, so you can make the numbers smaller. So if I divide this by 100, I'll make this number divided by 100. So now are visible. The same thing is valid also for the pip movement or the points. So if I divide the pips by 10, then this has been divided by 10. So this is mainly for display reasons, so you do not get too much information clogged together. Okay, let me see what else the indicator can do. As I said before, the indicator works both tick volume and real volume. Right now, since it's this volume type, it's set to true, we are using tick volume. If I switch it to false, it will use real volume. Okay, so right now we're using real volume. And I can also switch it here. There's no need on the pips. Then, these two parameters, weighted volume and weight all bars, it's under development, so don't worry about that, all this weighted stuff. And then we have a volume filter. What is that? The volume filter, it emphasizes on the large waves. Okay, we got a question probably. No, okay, let me continue. All right, so the volume filter emphasizes on the large waves, gives more emphasis on the large waves. So let me put it on just to see what I mean. We'll have a picture of how the Weis Wave looks now. And after I push the enter, okay, you can see that it's giving emphasis only on the big waves. All right, let me take that off. Okay. Colin, if you have any questions, you need to direct to me. Okay, because I'm not able to see the questions. All right.
I'll let you know for sure if there's any questions that pop up. But he was able to get it, no problem.
All right. So here the show labels will just turn off these labels on the chart. All right. Simple as that. Okay, labels are off. Okay, let me leave them off. And then waveline. The waveline. Do we want to show the waveline or not? If I take it off, it will remove the waveline. Let me put it back on. Waveline. Then this is the label shift for our labels. Okay, depending on the instrument we're trading, we need to shift the labels up or down in order not to touch each other or the swings. Let me show you an example. Let me put the labels on. All right. Now the label shift, it's 5. And these are the fonts for the labels. And these are the colors for the labels. So this is 5. Okay, and we get this. Now, if we want the labels to move further away from our prices, I will change the 5, for example, to 10. So much more distance. So they moved further up. Or change it to 50. Oh, sorry, this is the divider. Labels here, 50. Okay, so further away. Now this value can vary from 1 to several millions. It depends on the instrument. So it's quite adjustable. Now, let me put it back on where it was, close to where it was. 6, for example. Font size we can adjust for the labels. And then we start going to some alerts. The volume alert. What does this parameter do? As we're having the volume wave down here, okay, we can set a volume alert when the cumulative volume wave exceeds this line. Okay, now it's set up to be 50,000 something. It will give us an alert. Let me show you how this line is adjusted. So right now, the volume alert is at 50,000. If I'll make it 100,000, you will see the line moving up. Nice. MT5 got stuck. Hold on a second, let me restart it. MT5 does that sometimes. Okay, we need to go back to here. So let me take off the speed index from this one. Display speed index off. And I will put the wave line to 100,000. There we go. So in this case, when the volume, the cumulative wave exceeded this number right here, we'll have got the alert. What kind of alert? Any kind we like. And it can be set up from here. So this is our volume alert, and this is what kind of alert we like. A pop-up, sound, email, push notification, we got all these kinds of alerts. Okay? Next parameter is to display the speed index or not. So if I put true, we will see the speed index numbers coming up. Okay, it's independent of the rest of the labels. Let me go on. Enable speed index alert. So here we can have an alert on speed index. So what the alert does, we can set up an alert if a speed index is above a specific number that we place here, or if a speed index is below a specific number, which we can set up here. For example, let me look at these numbers here. Let me put this 65, for example. If it's above 65, okay, and I set up the alert to true, on the previous wave, the one that has been formed already, this is where the alert will come on, okay? So if I also put above 60, for example, and I put a native alert true, okay, this is what happened. We got the alert that we got a slow speed of 65 on bar with this number, this date, and at this time. Okay. And at the same time, apart from the alert, which it can be anything, we see the number is highlighted. Okay. So every number up here that is above 60 that I have set up the alert, it will get a different color, okay? But the alert will come only on the previous wave, the one that is formed, not on the forming one, okay? The forming one is already 70. Okay, since it's not formed, that's why we're not getting an alert. When it is formed and closed, we will get the alert. So even if we don't like the alerts, we can take them off. Here, same story here, we can put any kind of alert, email, push, sound, whatever we like. I will take them off now, and I will say, I need to see on chart to be more visible everything that is above 60 and everything that is below, for example, 25. It's just an example. So these two numbers, if it's below 25 or above 60, will be colored orange right here. The rest of the numbers will be colored black. So this is something visible for us. As you can see now, all above 60 are, and below 25 are marked with a color that we like. So this is basically the setup. Okay. As far as ways, I don't think there is anything else. We will see also later on. This is basically it, the setup. It's straightforward. The most important thing is to get the swings right. Okay, the numbers of bars back is the indicator, instead of going all the back in the beginning of the chart and you know, getting CPU, even though it's not that CPU intensive, you can choose to go back only, for example, 1,000 bars, 2,000 bars. So as soon as we have set up our Weis Wave indicator, which is this one, and right now we have it on auto difference waves and 6 sensitivity, we need to set up our peep wave the same. Okay, the peep wave itself, it's at 1,000 bars. it's a true auto difference, N6, so it has the same parameters with the Weis Wave. And also we need to put here real volume, which is real volume right here, okay? The weighted, as I said before, it's under development. Don't worry about that. Okay, basically that's it. We don't need to set up anything else. So right now, we see our setup here. So the auto waves is working with 38.8 points with sensitivity 6. And here, down here, we also see that we're working on the volume with real volume, not with tick volume. Okay, these zeros that you see here is for the under development weighted volume that I'm trying to create. So let me go back to the presentation, unless we have any questions on the setup. No questions? Okay. So we saw the visual. We saw the alert on volume. We explained that. We saw the alert on the speed index, if it's greater or if it's lower than the number we signify. Then, where to trade? As mentioned in the previous seminar, let me put my trade in specific locations, trade on support resistance, trade on pivots, trade on Fibonacci. If there is confluence, that is much better. Do not just trade anywhere. Now, how do I trade? Stop loss. Basically, when I monitor the trade, I don't use stop loss. The reason being that the market has been changing a lot, and I've seen false breaks and taking out stop losses 50, 60 pips. So personally, when I do monitor the trade, I do not use stop loss. My target, usually when I read the chart and I decide that if I'm going long or short, I will place two orders. One order I will close on a significant level, such a support resistance or a fib. And the second one, I will let it run. I will move my stop loss to zero and I will let it run. And then I will move my stop accordingly, depending on what I see on the chart. Now let's go to some trading examples to see how to trade with this stuff. Okay. Here I have a before and after picture, and I will explain to you how I read the chart. Okay. As you can see, we had a big drop. This is a Euro British pound. We had a big drop. This is 1 hour chart. And then we started moving up. Okay. As we move up, as you can see, I have drawn the fib area. So this is the fib. I've drawn the fib area. And what do I see happening here? Okay. The first thing I see is an abnormal speed index of 180.4. Nothing compared to the previous history, the recent one. This means something to me. This is an alert to me. I don't know yet if this is a first push down or if it's going to be continuation. So that's why I wait. As we're going along, we hit the fib again. We reach the 61.8 with a 96 speed index. That's a high speed index too, compared to these ones of all the up waves. Then we're going down, and then on the next touch with the fib, we get 111.5 speed index. So what does that tell me? These are all on the way up from here on. This was their first push down, okay? Tried to push the price down. And this is also visible apart from the speed index from here, we see this down volume, big down volume, but there is no pip move. So something is going to happen. So on the way up, we see the same story. Large volume, but no move. Why is that? The first case on the down volume is people are buying on the retracement and smart money is selling. We get the volume and it's absorbing orders. The same thing happens here in the opposite direction. People are buying again, but smart money is selling. The result is this drop that you see here. Okay, so we got high speed indexes at the top. We got volume without pip movement. Okay, that was the first push. After the first push, we expect for this to be a short, these things, high volume, no move. And this will happen. So we have touched 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 times, and then boom down. So that was a short. Okay, after this boom down, we can go down here. This was a 40 pip move after, let's say, this range break. So we approached a previous support level. Okay, what do we see here? We see high volume, okay, no move again. So this, again, something is going to happen here, and this is what happened, a boom up. All right. Any questions here? Let me continue. That's USD Japanese yen 1 hour chart. And let's see what happened here. We were going up. Then we started retracing again to a fib. All right. So what do we see? We see volume, down volume, not the respective move. Okay. So what I do after that, I'm going to the second chart, which is what happened after this. First of all, I have adjusted the waves a bit so I get more proper swings. So this line, this here, okay, is this one down here, this drop. So this 9.7 speed index became 17.8 as we went along. Okay, so we are going down, but without significant pip movement and with a high speed index. Look at the speed index, 17.8, and nothing like that on the down waves all the way from here to here. Okay, so this is an alert for us. Okay, next wave is up and is moving pretty easily. Speed index is 6 point something. It's an easy move. Then another down, we need to retest 11 and buy some more. That's what these guys are doing, retesting and buy some more. And as we can see, another speed index, which is quite high, 13.2. Okay, so what do? We wait for the break to confirm that our reading is correct, which is correct, and we go long. Okay, this was buying on the down moves. Easily identified, buying on the down moves. Another thing which is also helping us, apart from the waves, the pip wave and the speed index, is the volume. Look at the volumes down here, okay? So we got high volume at the bottom. Here, again, we got high volume at the bottom. So they're buying on these down moves, and then we explode. Any questions here? Let me type something. See if you guys have any questions. Any questions?
Yeah, any questions you guys have, just post them in the chat window, and we'll answer them for you. Okay?
No questions. All right, let me continue. Let me put my mouse on. All right. Euro USD. We're going up. We had a drop again in Fiberia. This happened in Fiberia. What do we see here? First of all, we are in a Fiberia, so we need to watch out if something is going to happen. When I'm talking about location, this is what I'm talking about.
There's a question. Is it true is it rule that moves opposite higher speed index?
Can you repeat, Colin?
Sure. Is it rule that move is opposite to higher speed index? Is it a rule that the move is opposite to a higher speed index?
No, it depends where we are. For example, let me go to the previous example. Huh? Okay. In this example, the move, yes, it's the opposite to the high speed index. Correct. Okay. But most of the time, we need to see the price raising. So we will see exactly the opposite. For example, here, the first move of the speed index, the 180, okay, we didn't see the move going up. Okay, why? Because this was the first absorption of the buy orders. That's the first absorption. After this, we need to check out what is happening. Okay, so what happened after that? This is the first absorption. Then we see up move high speed index, up move high speed index. Then it means exactly that it's the opposite, not here. Okay, always the first wave must be considered with the high speed index as an alert wave. Okay, it doesn't mean that the price will move some fast somewhere. It does sometimes, as it will here, for example. Okay, in this example, in a Euro USD, we dropped, we retraced to Fiberia. Then we see some other stuff too. We see, first of all, high volume. This is number two here. High volume at the bottom. Okay, right at the 61.8 line. There we see a high speed index on this up move. We see a 52. Okay, which is not a small speed index. It's quite significant. All right. And we see the volume, but no move. Okay. That was their push up. That was the first push up. That's why I said we need to wait after this, what is going to happen. Okay. Since we did not see any other up waves moving hard, having a hard time to move up, then this is probably a long, and this is what happened. This was an immediate reaction. Did I answer the question?
Yeah, that sounded pretty good. Yes, Zenon says thank you. Yes.
Okay.
Thank you for your question.
All right, let me go. Another thing we need to see here, we got this 52 up, hard time to move up. It doesn't mean it's hard time, it's absorption. Okay, people are selling here, smart money is buying, okay? That's why we see the price not moving. We got the volume. But look at this after the 52. Look at the volume number four that I have marked. It's huge on this down move. So I'm 100% sure that if we break this level up, the price will keep going up after seeing these four things. One, Fib. Two, volume at the bottom. Three, push up, high speed index. Four, another volume at the bottom. So 99% sure that we're going up. Okay? It's that easy. Just have to learn how to read this. Let me go on the next example. All right. We're going up. We're reaching, this is a British pound USD 1 hour chart. we are reaching a previous resistance daily. This is coming from a daily chart. So if we go all the way left here, there was some daily here with resistance. So as we can see, we have reached hit that daily, which also happens to be a 50 Fib area. So we need to watch out what is happening. Okay, we just see a 40 speed index. Is it abnormal? On the up moves, not so abnormal, because I can see 39, 36. But since I have reached there, okay, I will scroll down to the 5-minute chart. This is a 1-hour chart to see what happened up here. And this is what happened on the 5-minute up here. Okay, so this 40 up here, it's been analyzed like this on the 5-minute. That's 18.4. That's the first push down. What I said before, that's the first push down. High volume, no move, high speed index. Then on the wave up, we get another high speed index, high volume, again, no move. And then what else do we see? Look at the bottom. This volume down here, it's all the way at the top. Okay. As long as it breaks this level for me, it's a short. Okay. It means that all this up here was a short. And this is what happened. 100 pips down. Okay. From here to here. Right. From here to here. This exactly, this move on the 5-minute. So sometimes we need to drill out on the 5-minute. Okay. Any questions here?
No questions.
No questions. Okay. That's a euro Japanese yen 1-hour chart. We got a question?
Yes. Do you trade with a trend?
Most of the time, yes. Most of the time with a trend. If I do not trade with a trend, then I need to back up my reasoning for at least 2-3 days back to see what has been doing with volumes.
And then how would you establish a trend?
Usually I look at the daily 4-hour and 1-hour chart. Okay, look at the volumes. If the volumes are, for example, let's say it's a downtrend. If the price agrees with the volumes, means the price is moving down, and then volume waves, the down waves are higher than the up waves, then this is the case. An alert will be the volumes, the down waves to be higher and the price not moving down that easy. Okay, this is an example right here. Now, let me show you something. I'll start from the left, okay? We're going down, definitely this is a big down wave. We're going down, then we start retracing, okay? The volume is big on the retracement. The movement is almost zero, almost nothing, and we got a 62 pip speed index. That's a big number. No move, okay? We don't know yet if this is going to be the first push to start going up, or this could be a continuation. People selling on this up move. So what I'll do, I'll wait for this break to happen to make sure. If the break doesn't happen and we keep going, then I will examine the rest of the waves. And as you can see here, we broke very hard down. So this meant that this 62 was continuation, was not their first push. Okay. And look what happened later on. We start approaching a resistance. This is coming from the 4-hour chart. And it's also at the same time a Fib area. So if we were to look at the chart from all the way to the left, we will see some other point on the 4-hour chart. So this is also a Fib area. So I'm start examining what is happening here. Okay. So as we're going down and we are approaching 61.8. We see this huge down wave again. No pip move. And 69.4 speed index, which is quite high. The rest of the speed indexes on the down moves are 15, 38, 33, 18, 26. It's the highest speed index on the down moves. So this is an alert. What else do I see? Look at the volume on this pin bar. This is the highest volume. So I'm 90% sure here that this is going to break up. As soon as it breaks, I go long. Where is my first target? Will be somewhere up here. Small target. The rest, let it go. If it goes, it goes. One more. That's a daily chart. Okay, this happened sometime in September. I got some more recent ones. This is a daily chart. Now, first significant down wave all the way for I don't know how many days back, okay, after this up move. So that's the first significant down wave with pip movement. So nothing extraordinary. But what it tells us is that supply came in. This is what it tells us. Then we start going up with almost no volume and a high speed index, which means it has a hard time to move up. And we break again. Then we see a retracement. The retracement, it's on a daily fib, and a previous support became resistance. This support here became also resistance here. At the same time, it's a fib. Okay, what else do we have? We have a huge wave, nothing compared to the previous ones, okay? But the speed index is 202. This is quite huge. Okay, this means to me that it's having a hard time to move up. So I place a short around this area. Where is my stop loss? Somewhere up here. Okay, if I was to put stop loss, because this is daily, I cannot monitor the trade, so it will be somewhere up here. And this is what happened, 400 pips down. So speed index alert me. I also read this stuff. I had this background here. I had no significant pip move. Then I said short. Okay, before I say thank you, let me show you something which is recent. I got some screenshots here. Okay. Let's look at this break that happened yesterday. Okay. As you can see, this is Euro British Pound 1 hour chart. So where are we? Okay, this is, we're going up and downs, this is raging, but we have reached a support coming from daily. So all the way to the left, there's some daily support here. So we came with a big down wave, then I start studying the rest of the waves. As you can see here, we're going up, okay, easily. Okay, next thing we've seen is after this gap here, down move here, we see huge volumes, 1, 2, 3 bars, which is big, and it's 12 o'clock at night, Easter time, Eastern European time. So this is quite huge volume for this time. Then speed index, down move. 31, down move, 31, okay? The up speed indexes are lower. Number 5, high volume, no move, high speed index, 37. And then we close for the weekend, here, I think. And then we come up with a gap. We come up with a gap, and on the way down, we see a huge speed index again, 110. So all the speed indexes at the bottom are much higher than the top. So again, 99% sure that this is going to break up. And this is what happened. Okay, this happened on the 2nd of December, something like that. Let me show you one more. Before and after picture. Before, odd cut. All the stuff, I have it in my blog, and I also forecast the stuff. So I post before and after pictures. Do we have any questions?
Yeah, Zenon was wondering, so when is the moment to put on the position?
Yeah,
for instance, let me go back in this to the scenario that picture. You have here with these waves breaking lower.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
When is the moment here? If you are an aggressive trader, if you have seen this, okay, you will place the order somewhere at the bottom around here, okay, and move your stop loss further way down. If you want to make sure that all your reading is correct, then you should place your order after the break, somewhere around here. Okay? When I'm 100% of what I'm reading, it's correct, and I have so much background. I mean, this is a background of 1, 2, 2.5 days, okay? As I said, smart money needs time to absorb orders. They don't do it fast. Okay, most of the time, that's what I'm doing. I'm reading 2-3 days back. So with this background, I will just trade it anywhere. Okay, but if you are aggressive, okay, and you don't want to wait for the break, you can trade it anywhere in here. Somebody who's conservative will trade it after the break. That's a difficult part.
Then how do you develop the patience to that's wait a difficult for these part. Things to line up?
That's why I use also a trend line, a line cross. I have an indicator which I have created to give me alert when the price will cross that level, for example, or you can use the regular MT5 alerts for prices. And instead of sitting on the computer, and if you have analyzed all the stuff, you just wait for the price to move and give you an alert. Okay, I don't spend 3 days looking at this. I look at this 2-3 hours per day, and I decide my moves. I place my orders, okay? And then usually when I place them, I wait for a day or two to develop. Any more questions? And that's because I'm trading 1 hour. If I was trading 1 minute or 5 minutes, that's a different story. Okay.
Zenon says, thank you.
I will.
What you could do too, if you would put your information when you get a chance.
Two more examples.
Yeah, excellent.
First, this one. Okay. So as I have said, we're reaching daily FIB area down here. Okay. And then I see what? I see first this pin, okay, with all these huge volumes down here. Then we move down, we still keep moving down. The speed index, it's high, it's 18.8. There's nothing like that on this down move, 18.8, which means also here high volume, no significant move. Okay, so I don't know yet if it's going to break up. Let me show you what happened after this. Okay. This is the after picture. Okay, that was my first indication. Okay, but then I also look at the left and I had another location here. So the price, when there was no move here, we went a bit up, then we went down, we reached again, then we moved up again. Look at this, we got a 16.2 speed index, which is high. This means to me hard time to move up also. All right, so that's why we broke this level. But with this background here, this coming down very fast, because this is very fast move, it's not backed up, and having this number six volume at the bottom here, I knew it was going to go up. Okay, I got this background here. I got no moves. Okay, and then I see this. So I went long. Actually, this odd cut went all the way up to here. If somebody can check your thoughts, because this happened, I think, on the 29th of November, right now. Okay. So basically, that's it, guys. Let me put up my information if you have any more questions.
So do you use some areas of supply and demand as well?
I showed you. Okay, I don't use any, heat charts of volume. I use peep wave, waist wave, and the regular volume indicator. Then what I do is just draw support, resistance, and fibs. That's it. Any more questions?
Okay, so how to understand market is moving in one direction when number of sell and buy positions are equal? Usually that's when the market is in an area where
that's why it's having hard to move. When you have a lot of sells and a lot of buys and everybody's absorbing, retailers, for example, selling, smart money is absorbing all the sales with buys, the price is not moving much. So that's what I'm saying here. Let me go back. Euro, what happened? Okay. This is what happened in Euro. Okay, after this break, look at the speed index. It happened yesterday. Okay, and 2 days back. Look at this. High volume. And we're talking here with real volume, not a tick chart. Okay, this is real volume. But these are all the previous examples that I showed was with tick charts. Regular tick volume, not real volume. This is real volume. All right, look at this. This is their first push. This is what I'm talking about. Okay, buying here, 80 speed index. Then on the way down, we broke a bit, fake break, 54. Volume, but not the respective pip distance. That's why it's a 54. Then retracement. Okay. 59. And then high speed index. For this volume, if there were only sellers, okay, will be, the price would have been going down very fast. But here there are sellers and buyers. Who wins? The buyers. And that's why we moved up here. Did I answer the question? Okay.
I believe so, yes. It looks like that's the case, that you did answer it.
Any more questions? If, guys, you want to examine this further, okay, you can visit. I have here, and I can... Actually, let me put it in. This is my blog, okay? And you can check out what I'm posting almost daily, not daily, but with before and after. So I'm posting real time. which means I know what I'm doing. Eh? So let me post this address here. So this is my blog. Okay, and if you want to see videos, also you can check my YouTube channel from my site. My site, it's this one. Okay. So, and I'll be, you know, be happy to answer any questions later on by email or anything they like.
Okay, great. And again, for those of you that are here, this will be in our on-demand archives. So if you need to go over any of it again, don't hesitate to check that out on our website, www.ampglobal.com. And also for the attendees, you'll get a copy of this sent to your email.
Thank you all. Thank you all for listening
all right.
to me.
Thank you so much for, yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. And I'm sure we'll hear from you again in the future. All right, attendees, thanks again for tuning in. Thanks for your attention, and we'll talk. Have a good one.